Para nuestro surf, Lab.org.
If you don't have your tickets for this event, it's only just begun. Get them quickly. Here we go. Orwan starting it off. Crushing forehand down the line. A defender needs this in today's game. The attacker on screen from Thailand will be reminded how focused and intentional she has to be in the touch game. Cracking forehand comes back just long. They split the first 2 points here. Now it's tough to imagine, but a defender, the red side of the racket for Linda Bergstrom, the backhand typically, has a very different effect on the ball than when she plays it with her forehand. Forehand for Linda Bergstrom, the more attacking rubber racket set up this way. And there it is once again, following her tomahawk serve quickly. Again, pressure. You might think the attacker could just relax, let the defender defend all day long, but defenders in the modern game have developed a strong attack.
1-4.
Good float push there, a little bit less rotation on it. So when Paranong lifts, it carries long. That forehand is killer, and it's worth its weight in gold. It's on the other side, despite looking at a weighty gold necklace there. Right now, Orwan Paranong still trying to figure out how she can touch the ball, control, and keep Linda Bergstrom off the attack. Looking for the angles here, working with the spin, that left-handed step around.
Six.
Good pressure, not deep to the backhand, but straight to it there. Keep a look at Linda Bergstrom's touch on the last one. A little more shallow, you could see she had to come in for the ball. So quick to turn around. Linda Bergstrom right now is making it a nightmare for Paranong on the other side. We've seen a lot of passive play from Thailand's leading lady. Crushing forehand, the power with the flat hit right into the backhand. Not easy to hit the ball that fast from low without topspin. Or with minimal topspin, I should say. Once again, finds her way, Linda Bergstrom in the pushing rally. They go back and forth in the backhand. Linda Bergstrom earning herself the attack, goes for the parallel for the win. Strawberry action where she lifts the wrist. Side spin to go with that varying spin from the backhand. Keep your eyes on it. There it is, underspin and side spin. And it's tough to know how much of which is on it. 6-point lead at the second towel break. They come up every 6 points. The flat hit again, not easy to do, but making it count here to the wide forehand. Paranong punishing that ball. Spin on the first one, a standard to set up the put away. Crushing forehand once again, and the defender on the attack is becoming the pattern here, earning her options. Wiggling around to find the opportunity and the killer finishing shot. 6 game points for Linda Bergstrom. A nice touch on this one as Paranong survives. Survives with an R in it. This news just in. 5 game points left. And the touch, there it is. It's the threat, the beware of dog sign waiting on the other side there. The mountain stream herself streaming through that first one.
One love.
Now the tomahawk serve that we're seeing from Linda Bergstrom against the left-hander puts her in a good position. She's comfortable with the forehand waiting.
One.
Strawberry attempted, but Parinong with a good deep push. Little surprised considering how many forehand winners Linda Bergstrom has played so far. She went a little bit more passive on that.
One, two.
You might be thinking, well, she's a defender. She plays passively. But if you watched game number one, she plays passively when she has to. And then she earns opportunities, but constantly varying the ball. Nice spin, good aggression into the forehand here. Orawan Parinong is going to be a bit more familiar with the black side of the racket. Linda Bergstrom turning it around for a spinny backhand serve. Nice change of pace. Parinong slows it down and makes the ball dip and dive. Defensive rackets tend to be a little bit bigger, a little bit slower.
And
a much better start this time around. Orawan Parinong with four of the first 6 points. Inside out forehand, more of that flat hit shot.
Two.
Linda Bergstrom isn't going to use quite as much spin when she attacks as she's hitting to finish the point.
Parinong
just barely catching the edge of the table there as she goes to the line. A little bit more secure in the spin. Footwork as an attacker against a defender is crucial. Patient play throughout, and finally the first moment that didn't seem patient favored Linda Bergstrom. The blocking game of Orawan Parinong right now, very confident in that last rally. Good variation in the pushing game. Just a step behind the table, a bit more chop, some strawberry side spin there. Makes it so uncomfortable, we've seen a few times now. And a bit more aggressive early, but still keeping the spin on. There didn't seem to be any panic in that. Orawan Parinong driving the ball deep. And extends her lead back to two. Still in play, but it's put away off the bounce. When the top spin comes in, the attacker's much more comfortable, partially because they don't have to generate their own power. The ball's rushing into the racket. The timing is familiar. Completely different game number two. Orawan Parinong, for me, between the calm, between the control and the push game, but the blocking game, slow spinny shots, not feeling pressure to finish the point. And this is crucial against defenders, along with footwork. Patience. But this one sits up high after the net ball. Parinong apologizing, but extending her lead to a 5-point lead after being just one ahead. Good coverage, keeps it deep with topspin, and leaves Linda Bergstrom behind the table. 6-game points now for Thailand's leading lady, the lefty with the serves. A whole lot of nets in this rally, but it's Linda Bergstrom to recover, saving a game point. This is that never give up attitude on both sides, having to rush in. If it gets a second bounce on the table, point immediately over. Flat hit down the line, does it, and Parinong ties it up at one game apiece. Good spin to the wide forehand. When Linda Bergstrom's way behind the table there with that forehand, she loves to play topspin with that forehand. She's got a lot to cover on the backhand side. You saw the twiddle there. Linda Bergstrom turning the racket around early in the rally to vary the spin. And then she has to quickly twiddle back. We saw with the red on the backhand for the final shot.
One, two.
Coach Tobias Quickly reminding Linda Bergstrom that her service game is strong. Ooh, deep shot right to the baseline. Racing off, catching the hand of Orwan Paranong. Still table there, but just barely. The hand raised caught the edge, which is why the ball shot off. It's such an amazing brain game playing a defender, partially because you're not used to it. Most people don't have practice against defenders, or limited compared to attackers.
Four, two.
And the amount of underspin or backspin that a chopper can put on the ball is incredible. Tobias Bergman there, coach. It really forces the attacking player to not only move her feet, but get low, lift with her legs to make sure she lifts the ball and keeps it out of the net.
Four, three.
But a low center of gravity anyway is Orwan Paranong, the smaller of the two players. For Team Thailand, the top three women, she's the smallest of the three. It's that threat of the forehand waiting in the push game. Orwan Paranong, down by two, gets the serves back. Again, the side of the table that Linda Bergstrom is on, has been the more successful side. Smart placement here. Shallow to the forehand side when Linda Bergstrom was deep on the backhand corner. It's interesting to see the shape of the racket and how that differs. You'll see different shapes out here. Defenders a little bit bigger, the rackets. The spin and the placement on this one. For the second time in this rally, we saw Linda Bergstrom attack with heavy topspin, but a bit more drive, a bit more forward motion behind it. After the slower spinny forehand, get ready. Steps around, a lot of footwork to go. Another break off the net here for a tight game. Fairly even so far between these two, the fortune. How many times have we seen that little bit of strawberry juice mixed into the smoothie here causing trouble? When she puts side spin on it, it leaves a lot of question on the other side. How much? And almost every time, it's come back into the backhand side of the net on Linda Bergstrom's backhand side. Not easy to play, but Linda Bergstrom has played it consistently. A lot of footwork to recover on the step around. Smart placement as Bergstrom plays it out more to the forehand side, hitting the middle. Take a look. That ball, no, wide forehand. From that camera angle, you could see how far Paranong had to go. Big streak here, Linda Bergstrom. 4-point lead, is moving around well. Relying on the topspin a little bit more, playing slightly more securely, reliable with that forehand. And Tomahawk serve once again sets up 5 game points. If Linda Bergstrom wins on this point, that'll be the third game in a row where the losing player has scored 5 exactly. Ooh, almost the save.
10.
Little break here and the pattern is broken as Paranong gets a break off the net. Get ready for the Shinhan Bank shout out here from Linda Bergstrom right into that little patch.
Seven, 10.
2 game point saved, and Linda Bergstrom cleaning off the rubber on the forehand side. The smooth inverted rubber, as we call it, for the spin game. Test of stamina and the finishing shot. She takes her chances. Orwan Paranong puts it away under pressure. three game points saved. The soft block, the touch deep to the backhand, one spin, not an easy ball. This is often a ball that the attacker will miss, trying to finish the point out of frustration. Laser-like focus from Paranong. That's Linda Bergstrom with two game points left and a serve that's been effective. And despite the good receive, it's an escape. Linda Bergstrom here just deflects and reverses the spin of her opponent. There it is, the forehand flat hit kill shot. Linda Bergstrom back in action. Quick step around, a little height on it. That ball bends to the corner. Catching the edge ever so slightly. I love that Paranong, even though she noticed, wanted to make sure that Linda Bergstrom did and let Linda Bergstrom call it first. Wonderful sportsmanship on both sides. Top edge of the racket. After driving it right to the middle, Paranong putting the pressure on. Good placement. Defenders, like attackers, have a middle. And defenders, as we've seen, are attackers for a good percentage of the time. Some more than others, of course. Linda Bergstrom. Game one was dominant with the attacks. Orawan Paranong evolving a bit, developing her game. This ball from that angle looked like one that Bergstrom will make quite often.
Two, three.
Impressive play here as Bergstrom comes back for the tomahawk serve. Nice pressure down the line, deep to the backhand, quick off the bounce. Paranong with the parallel. The tomahawk serve, like pretty much every serve at this level, can be delivered with very subtle differences in contact, and it makes it so challenging for the receiver to read.
Five, two.
Well, she recovered from the twiddle. Linda Bergstrom turned the racket around in the very early part of the point, just before this, to put extra spin on her backhand push. Oftentimes, players with long pips get shots with no spin into their backhand.
Two, six.
Some of the best advice I ever received. If you are serving into long pips, generally speaking, serve long and dead. Then the ball comes back long with little spin on it, dead.
2-7.
Touch game as Paranong keeps it baseline. Bergstrom, when she goes back for a little bit more topspin, her percentages go up, but doesn't finish the rally. There it is, and it does this time around. Heavy topspin, the more secure shot. Paranong with a little self-diagnosis says, I need to stay forward, lean in, keep my racket closed. This one is killer. When she steps around, Bergstrom's got the length of the table. And for these flatter shots, it's very helpful. A little bit of side spin of her own there, Paranong, but from down low here, you can see the ball popped up a bit. Interesting. Some nets here and there throughout. Nice recovery from Bergstrom. Earns herself a good opportunity. Not easy, though, when the ball's shallow on the table. You can only get your legs so far under the table. So the table itself doesn't move. It's an obstacle for both players that they try to use to their advantage as an obstacle. Strawberry once again. Linda Bergstrom coming back in. No timeout called yet for Paranong.
Stop!
She She's saving it, doing her job. 2 points away from sending this to the decider here, Paranong. Very calm. When the topspin comes in, she's got less work to do. And variation in her own push game. First one light spin, and then a few heavy pushes. It's 5 game points for Thailand's Orawan Paranong. Ooh, double happiness. The top of the net, the edge of the table here. Linda Bergstrom saves a game point. But tell me, when's the last time you saw Orawan Paranong open up with a topspin backhand? First I can recall. A little bit of topspin off the backhand again. 3 game points left. Still saving that timeout. It's Linda Bergstrom with her second serve. There it is. Paranong takes it and sends it to the decider. And now it's Orawan Paranong with a bit. Paranong, rather, with a bit of momentum.
One love.
And an outright service point. As our Seah ball kid quickly glides through the court, keeping it smooth, keeping it clean. Perfect placement here. Once again, Paranong able to really move around Linda Bergstrom in this rally. Surprise push, short motion there, keeping it unpredictable. After recovering two nets in this rally, this is going to mean a lot for the morale of Linda Bergstrom. There can be this feeling of, man, how many times from my opponent? But with the focus, she just clears her mind, stays in the point. Bergstrom, patient play. And the aggressive forehand where she can find it keeps the top spin on, and it's 2 points each. Something hypnotic about the rhythm of an attacker versus a chopper. Nice drive on the parallel here. Paranong to that forehand plays the spin game. She's varied it well. Remember, the first time these two have ever played internationally. Against each other, that is. And after a lot of answers to the strawberry side spin, the big attacks. Moving back into the table, Linda Bergstrom finds a way to increase the pressure and cause some problems. Fast, right from near the baseline. The in and out game, choppers know it well. Tactically, Paranong doing everything right to play one attack and go back to the pushing game, not having to deal with too much of her own topspin coming back as heavy underspin. That strawberry is so fast. One of the most aggressive shots we've seen off the backhand yet from Linda Bergstrom. They will switch sides as one player's reach five. There it is. Look at that. Tough to tell exactly what spin was on it. The side spin we know, but how much? What combination? Puzzling. Flat hit, kill shot, earns the opportunity and capitalizes when it appears. Paranong making it a 1 point game. The amount of speed on that opening spin shot from Paranong. So much spin. Bergstrom moving Paranong to the wide forehand and not allowing time for her to get planted. to really get the energy from the ground up, the legs to lift that ball. Bergstrom with a little net of her own on the second to last one and capitalizes on the follow-up. 3-point lead here. Wow, before that, six of the last eight and one more. Linda Bergstrom with some serious momentum into the second towel break in the final game of this match. Sweden's Linda Bergstrom in a very encouraging position. Paranang fighting back with serves here to come, two of them. Nice drive into the middle. From time to time, we've seen that heavy drive against a chop. How fast that is in the replay. She's so smooth and effortless in this shot. To the deep corner as well. Paranang fighting back. It's a 2-point game now. We've seen bigger comebacks, but every game so far, the next game has had almost the exact opposite answer. Still a lot up for grabs, yet to be determined. But that tomahawk serve. Linda Bergstrom 2 points away from a round of 16 appearance. Too much pressure and perfect placement. Linda Bergstrom right into that elbow sets up 4 match points. Remember, 4 major events. And this is one of them. A lot of points up for grabs. Paranang still alive, saves a match point. Linda Bergstrom just breathing on and cleaning off that spinny forehand side of the racket. Doesn't miss the edge by much. 7 serving 10. Oh, and that is the match. Linda Bergstrom takes it 3-2.